Your client published an editorial cartoon which depicts the Prophet Muhammad being humiliated.
Being body scanned at an airport metal detector.
And while all the other white passengers are waved through.
It was intended to criticize racial profiling.
All the while, your client knew that Islam prohibits any pictorial depiction of the Prophet. You know what happened in Denmark. The Morning Post published cartoons just like this. Riots. Death threats.
This isn't about Mrs. Sanborn, Jonas. This is about us.
Of course it's about us. I'm gonna destroy your firm.
My job is to provoke.
Because it sells papers?
Because freedom of the press is meaningless unless somebody actually uses it.
The problem, Mr. Clay, is their argument is you did it to increase circulation.
It's not like I commissioned this cartoon hoping it was gonna anger Muslims. We had an online contest. Best political cartoon, any subject.
Yeah, it was my idea. Some jerk at the airport gave me a hard time, so I drew about it. First, I made it just a picture of a random Muslim. Then I thought, what the hell?
Language.
I mean, if I'm gonna make a statement, why not really make a statement, you know?
So it was your idea to depict
the Prophet, yeah. Somebody had to do something or the fundies win.
The
fundamentalist.
I emailed Clay, told him I wanted to change the cartoon. Put it out in the open, get other Muslims to re-examine their preconceptions.
Then why do it anonymously?
Hey, I'm 15 years old. Why do I do anything?
You have to understand. I knew nothing about any of this, not until after.
And would you be willing to testify about all of this, Tariq?
No, it's not up to Tariq.
Well, he could testify in camera in the judge's chambers. There would only be the judge, the lawyers, the court reporters. We would use a pseudonym.
Mrs. Florek, Miss Sharma. I know the name of only one cartoonist, Kurt Westergaard, the man who drew one of the cartoons of Muhammad in the Danish paper 5 years ago. And he has been living under 24-hour security since then. I will not do that to my son.
Stern's theory is that Clay wanted a violent backlash. That rests on the fact that he cut back security.
Yeah, but if the bomb came from inside, no security would have been able to prevent it.
Right.
Stern will still argue that the bomb was planted by a radical Islamic group. They just had help from inside.
So talk to the employees.
That could help. A lone bomber in the office.
How many Muslim employees does he have?
Can't be many.
So we're going to racially profile? The exact thing the cartoon was against?
No. We're going to step nicely past the ironies and defend our client.
You know what I don't understand? We're still treating this like it's jihad, even though it's an inside job.
Because of the threat, the bomb?
Look, you were talking about racial profiling, right? What if someone was using our bias to make us think it was jihad when it was really something else?
Asking you to focus on this man today, Matthew Wade. Now, I know many of you may recognize him, Detroit Pistons 2000, but I still need you to judge him purely as a politician, a corrupt politician.
Think, man. I thought you were supposed to distract me.
This is distracting you.
What, distracting me with fouls? Here we go.
Nice guy. Mm-hmm. I saw him at UCLA in 97, played like a demon.
Sorry, hon, looks like I won't go for another day.
So did he do it?
Do what?
Whatever they're charging him with.
He's a black Muslim alderman in the city's poorest ward. He was wiretapped saying, I don't know what. My guess is it doesn't matter if he did it. Music's off, and he's the one without a chair.
The problem isn't corruption, the problem is terrorism.
What?
They say he took extremist money. 30 years to life.
I need you to take this.
Well, I heard it's just federal overreach.
I know, but they may have stumbled onto something they can win. Anti-Muslim bias.
Wiretaps are hard. Juries love them.
I know, that's why I need you to take this. Get it kicked in pre-trial motions. He will lose in front of a jury.
And if I advise him to cop a plea?
It's your call.
Don't forget, if you find anything, knock on my door.
Hey, Alderman. Got a moment?
Yeah, why wouldn't I? It's only 5 a.m.
I'm sorry, did I wake you?
How much, Royce?
30,000.
So we talking Islamic extremist here?
The two men discussed Mr. Wade's faith and joked that the only people who would contribute money to him were Islamic extremists. This then became their running gag.
A running gag unaccompanied by laughter, Your Honor.
Yes, this tends to happen in human conversation. You will find at these moments in the wiretaps, Mr. Wade and Crombie joked with laughter about Muslim extremists. In my opinion.
It does seem a little odd, Miss Vashi, that someone who was an actual Muslim extremist would refer to associates as Muslim extremists. Do you have anything else?